looming over the first day of school is the possibility of a labor dispute. Teacher contracts expired 4 days ago, and while they can often go months without a contract with no labor issues, the Ford government has set the stage for challenging negotiations.
We expected that this round of negotiations would be difficult, but we really had no idea of the attacks that this government were prepared to make. And the cuts that they stood behind right up until the end. One of the very first things we did was we asked our members to make a pledge to publicly funded public education. And at the end of that, we had over 40,000. Labor Day was extremely important, and that Labor Day gave us the ability to bring people together. Hundreds of thousands of union members, teachers, educators, education workers, and other unions, public and private sector, with a focus on what was ahead of us along with all other unions. And around that time, I think we launched one of our first commercials, Children Are Our Future, and really put the focus on students and how those efficiencies would affect students. And shortly thereafter, we launched a really successful hashtag Cuts Hurt Kids. And that was our key focus, to take it away from, this is not about money, this is about the stability of publicly funded education in this province. In the fall, when we realized that there was no movement at the table, we got to a point where sending a message to the government was extremely important. And those strike votes were phenomenal. Our members provided us at both tables with an overwhelming 98% strike vote. Unheard of. It was from the ground up. It was our members across this province saying, these are our issues and we're here for our team. And with that 98% mandate, it was like they were sitting at the table with us. And it sent a very clear message to the government. We're prepared to do whatever it takes to defend students and publicly funded education. Parents were actually at the center, and community groups were at the center of everything we were doing. And I have never experienced anything like it in doing this work in over 20 years. Three or four different parent networks were created across the province.
Let's have a fully funded Ontario public education system. It's what our kids deserve, it's what all kids deserve, and we need to keep pushing back against these cuts.
They took the initiative to organize walk-ins at over 700 schools across the province, where educators, parents, and students met before the school day and went into that school together to make a statement. I attended one of them, and I could not believe the support and the solidarity of parents on those issues. And it was a great way to start the day and a great way to start this campaign with parents.
The battle is getting testier between teachers' unions and the Ford government. Unions are launching a legal challenge against the PC's cap on salary increases.
And then the government introduced Bill 124, an absolute blatant violation of the charter and our collective bargaining process. And it affected all four teacher affiliates, as well as all public sector unions. In November, we had the OFL convention. So we had all of the public private sector unions and the labor movement in Ontario come together and pass motions in support of education workers and against the cuts. And that was important for us because we were in this together. So we realized we needed to be on the same page. And the labor movement in Ontario and across the country agreed. You know, initially when the government wasn't responding and they weren't serious in terms of their proposals at the table, we started to look at and implement a gradual work to rule. And that work to rule led into December. And there was absolutely no real movement at the table. And one of the things that happened at the end of December was the government representative told us at that time was that he had no mandate from the government to put any substantive proposals on the table or to negotiate the things we had. And even with our work to rule, that continued. So at that time, we felt it was absolutely necessary to move to a full withdrawal of services and take this to a whole other level.
I'd rather be in the classroom with my kids, but I will be here because not only am I fighting for the kids in my room, but I'm also fighting for my own children as a parent.
And we brought some Timbits too.
Just to show our support to the teachers.
Hands off FDK! Hands off FDK! Hands off FDK!
Shame on our minister who doesn't know who DECEs are, who doesn't understand the kindergarten model, who doesn't understand the great work that you do. So thank you for standing strong on the line.
20 years ago, we needed to do this in the days of Mike Harris, and we are standing on the shoulders of the teachers who stood strong and defended public education. It's never been about the money. It's about the kids.
When you take on this kind of a fight, you don't want it to be top down. And to walk that picket line, to walk up to a picket line and actually see that they were actually leading this whole effort, that whole struggle, that whole fight back, is just absolutely heartwarming and inspiring. You know, in addition to the overwhelming support from parents was the support that we got from the labor movement, every teacher union across the country, faculty associations from coast to coast to coast were sending letters of support and on social media. February the 21st was a historic day for the first time in history that all four teacher affiliates would be on strike on the same day, with hundreds of thousands of our members making a statement. And I will never forget that day. Thousands upon thousands at Queen's Park and across this province telling this government we're not going away and this is just the beginning of what we're gonna do to continue this fight. That joint collective message that we sent to the government pushed the government to come back to the table in early March. Small movement, but big movement in terms of where we were a month before. And the first day back at the table, I think it was the Thursday before March break, it became very apparent that COVID-19 and this pandemic was going to change everything in the province. So we pushed and pushed during March break and then over that week and got to where we needed to be. We were able to stop every one of the efficiencies or the deep cuts. If you look at our agreement, there are no strips to that agreement. And we actually increase the staffing numbers and the positions and resources for students with unique learning needs in the system. But I will never forget, nor will the bargaining team, that that was only possible because of everything that our members and parents and the labor movement did. But we can't relax now. We can't become complacent. And we need to make sure that we continue that work we started with the labor movement and parents in this province and all education stakeholders to ensure that the Doug Ford regressive conservative government does not get reelected. But regardless of the government and their political stripe, we will always be here to defend publicly funded public education, to defend our professions, and to defend students and our collective agreements.